हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू सिक्योरिटी इन कंप्यूटिंग प्रैक्टिकल्स। वी स्टार्ट विद दिस कॉन्फ़िगर राउटर्स फॉर दिस आर द फोर थिंग्स वी विल बी डूइंग द फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल। OSPF MD5 ऑथेंटिकेशन, NTP प्रोटोकॉल टू लॉक मैसेजेस टू द सिसलॉग सर्वर, द नेटवर्क टाइम प्रोटोकॉल दिस NTP एंड टू सपोर्ट SSH कनेक्शन। सो दिस फोर थिंग्स वील बी डूइंग। If possible, I'll try to do all the four things in one practical itself. If it is not possible, then we'll do part A, part B, and so on for the first practical. So we'll start with OSPF first. Now, for all the four parts of the practical, we'll use this topology. So we have two servers. This particular server is the NTP server, and this is the IP address. It's better we can note down this on the piece of paper, and then we'll make this topology on Cisco packet tracer. Here we have the syslog server. This is the IP address. We have two routers. This one router 0, router 1. Then two switches and two PCs, PC0, PC1, and all the IP addresses are also given. So we'll use this particular topology, and we'll make the above router as the NTP. And the below one as a syslog, and we'll check the we'll do all the four practicals on this particular topology. So it is better if you note it down this addresses. Next, we implement the topology in Cisco Packet Tracer. So this is the Cisco Packet Tracer software. We have to implement that topology in this particular software and verify all the protocols. The first one we'll do is the OSPF. So now let us take the server. The first server, the server can be found on this particular option. So here we have the server. Then we take the second. We need two servers. Then we need two switches. So switches, switches can be found here. Switches. The first one, this one, 2960. So I take this. Then one more here. And I need two routers. So routers the. We can take 1941, then one more 1941 router. If I take 1841, then I won't get that gigabit Ethernet. So in this case, I guess gigabit connection. So then next I take PCs. So this is PC, the two PCs. Now next we make the connection. For connection, I click here. This one, the solid one wire, the fast Ethernet of this. To any of the fast Ethernet can be connected. Similarly, fast Ethernet of this can be connected to any of the fast Ethernet. There are many available. Then next we have to connect to the router one, switch to router one. Now you have to take care that we must remember which connection we are doing at the router end. So you can see there are two gigabit Ethernet connections 0/0/0/1. So we must know what we are connecting. I will take 0/0. Then next I have to connect this router with this router one. So I take this one, the dotted one. Okay. So this gigabit 01 with this gigabit 01. I can connect any of the two, but I must remember what I am connecting. Then next I connect this wire 00 to here, any of the terminal. Then next from here to any of the terminal can be connected. Then here any can be connected to this one. So here we have fast Ethernet. So this completes the connection. Now after the connections, we see this all the terminals which are connected to switch with respect to the server and the PC, they turn on green, but the terminals which are connected to router, they are not turning. We have to turn in them, okay, turn in on. But first of all, we'll just put the IP address, okay, configure the servers and the routers, okay. So we can check if you have drawn the topology on a book, we'll go by that. So first of all, this server, I have to name this as a syslog. So I will just write, I can write it here also. Syslog, this is a syslog server. I can make caps. This is the syslog server. And this one is the NTP server. I can make the name change here itself. So now I have to configure this. So I'll click here. Double click. Okay. After double click, I can go to desktop and this IP configure. So IP configure, I have to put this address 192.168.1.2, and then subnet mask will come automatically. Now see, default gateway. Default gateway is the address of this particular router, this particular end, this particular interface, which is actually, if we see the notes, it is 192.168.1.1. Okay. So now this is configured. Okay. We'll turn on the service afterwards. Okay. Then we go to the NTP server. NTP server, same thing, desktop, the IP configuration. So this is actually 192.168.1.3. And this will come up, and this is of course the same address, 192.168.1.1, the address of this particular router interface. So this is done. Okay, it automatically gets saved, so we just close it. Now we come to router 0. We need to configure this router 0, and remember this this interface, this is actually 00. Okay, so we come to the configure, and this you can see this 00. We click on 00 and turn it on. As soon as we turn it, this becomes green. Okay, so now the address is 192.168.168.1.1. Okay, this is what we get. Okay, then we come to the next, this interface, the red one. Now we come to 01 and turn it on. Okay, it won't turn it because this has also been turned on. So then the address is actually 192.168.2.1. So now this router is configured, our address is configured. Now we come to this router. So this interface is actually 01. So this 01 with this 01. So I come here, configure. First I'll configure 01. See, as soon as I turn it on, this turns green. So the address is 192.168.2.2. This will come automatically. Now next, this one, this interface 00, this one. So I'll first turn it on, it will give green. It turns green. So next, this address is 192.168.3.1. Okay, and it will come automatically. Now we turn it off, we have to close it. Now we come to the PCs. This PC at the top, it is having address. We go to the desktop. This address is 192.168.3.3. Okay. And the subnet mask will come automatically. Now this default gateway is the address, is the IP address of this particular interface, this one, which is 3.1. So it is 192.168.3.1. This gets configured. Now we come here, give the IP address. Okay, this is 192.168.3.2. This will come automatically. This is 192.168.3.1. Okay. So this all the address, we have configured the address. Okay, now we have to set the OSPF protocol. Okay, now after configuring the addresses of the various hosts, servers as well as routers, now we will ping, we'll try to ping a message. We'll just ping a message from PC0 to this server, syslog server. Okay, I'll just mark it. So this particular syslog server, okay, or anyone, this one server also. So what that this is 192.168.1.2. This is the address of this particular server. So let us type a ping from this particular PC. We'll just ping. Okay. So I type, just click on it, and on address, on this prompt, I just type ping 192.168.1.2. Now this is what I get the message: destination host is not reachable. Now why it is not reachable? Because we have not configured the path. We need to configure the path, and we'll use the OSPF for the same. Okay, now let us see how we can configure the OSPF. Now before configuring the OSPF, we will see there are three networks in this case. Here we see this is our network 192.168.1.0, this network. Then this network is 192.168.2.0, and this is the third network, 192.168.3.0. We also need to find the wildcard mask. So for this particular network, the wildcard mask is 0.255.255.255. This is common for all the networks. So we will use this particular thing and configure the OSPF protocol on both the routers. So we start with the first, this router 0. Okay, we go in the CLI mode. So in the CLI mode, we see this, we have to enable. Okay. So then we write configure terminal. Then the command router OSPF 1. Now we need to add the network. Now as seen, this particular router is connected to two networks. Okay. So we need to add those network. So network 192.168.1.0, and then we'll add the wildcard mask 0.255.255.255, and we name the area 1. So this is added. Now we need to add another network, which is actually 192.168.2.0, and with the same wildcard mask. So okay, this is done now. Okay, next we come to router number 1. This one we have configured router 0 for OSPF. Now we come to router 1. Again in router 1 we have this, we enable and then configure terminal. Then again the same command, router OSPF 1. Now we need to add, here also we need to add two networks. First is 192.168.2.0 and area 1. Sorry, I forgot the wildcard mask. I will add the wildcard mask. So this is 0.255.255.255. Now it's okay. Then again, the second network is 3. In these two networks we have to add for this particular router. Now both we have added the thing, added the paths, the OSPF has been configured. Now we can check the connectivity. Okay, let us check. We will ping from PC1 to any of the two servers. Okay, so I just type it here, then command in the command prompt I type the command ping, and I do the address of this particular server is 192.168.1.3, I think so. Okay, let us see if we are getting the reply from the server. Okay, so we are getting the reply. Okay, the first packet is lost, but the all the other packets they are arriving. So we get success. We can again do the same thing. Okay, now we are getting 100% success. We can also check the connectivity from this side. Okay, we can on the command prompt we can again ping any of the PC, and we do any of the PC 192.168.3.2, one of the PC's address. Now you can see we are getting the reply from here also. So this completes the OSPF protocol. Now next we do the MD5 authentication, and we perform MD5 authentication on this two interfaces of router. Router 0, this one gigabit 01 and here is the 01. So I click on this router and then enable, then configure terminal, and then I need to select the interface gigabit 0/1, and now I have to configure the authentication part. authentication in message digest. I made a misspelling mistake. Then I have to select the key. So again, IPOSPF message digest key. So I select key as 1 and MD5. I name the key as smile. So this is set. I exit. So this is done. Now we go to the next router. This router, type the same command in CLI mode. So enable and then configure terminal. Now we need to select the interface. So same interface gigabit 0/1, then IPOSPF authentication. Okay. And of course message digest. Then again the same command. I have to define the key now. Message digest key is 1 and the same MD5 smile. So this is done. So we can exit from it. And again exit. So this is done. Okay. Next, to check the MD5 authentication, we go to router 0, click here and enable. Now next is show IPOSPF interface, and we have to see gigabit, and of course it is 0/1. Will show the whether it is okay. So see, you can see your message digest authentication is enabled. So and this key is 1. So that is our conclusion. So MD5 authentication has been enabled. Okay. So that completes the first part of this practical, OSPF and of course MD5 authentication. So that's all for this practical session. Thanks for watching.